I've been using ChatGPT since December of 2022, and in the last 3 years or so, I actually save all my favorite prompts. So in this one video, I wanted to share with you the 30 best prompts I ever found for ChatGPT and other AI chatbots, and I'll make this available for you to download as well. And I'll jump between ChatGPT and Gemini because sometimes Gemini actually will be a better fit for some of these prompts, and I'll kind of walk you through what these prompts are meant to do. The first one is called God Mode Research Prompt. Some of these I actually found online, but I don't have really good references on where to find them. So if you actually came up with this prompt, let me know so I could credit you in our PDF here. So this is act as a world-class researcher, analyze the topic from every angle, and it's gonna have expert reviews, historical patterns, scientific reasoning, create a structure summary, prioritize depth and clarity. Now, this one you could use just regular search, or if you want, you could turn on deep research and combine this prompt with deep research. This is typically how I like to use it. And I usually give it access to things like Dropbox because we do store a lot of different documents and research in our Dropbox here internally. So it will be able to extract information from that as well. Right now, just for the sake of time, I'll just show you what this looks like if you send it as a regular non-deep research prompt. And then it's gonna ask for your topic, the future of AI in small business here. And it's gonna give you all the different sections that I asked for. So key insights, patterns, controversies, blind spots, and it gives you resources here, links to everything that it got that information from here. And it's become one of my favorite go-to prompts when I'm starting to research any topic, especially when I combine this with deep research and my own information in my Dropbox. The next one on my list is called the Life Operating System Prompt. And this is to create an entire operating system for your life, including values, principles, decision filters, weekly routines, habit systems, all this information. For this one, I actually like to use the thinking model. In fact, for just about every single prompt I'm sharing you, because the prompts actually require a lot of details, I like to change inside of ChatGPT to a thinking model. If you do use Gemini or even Claude, I would turn on the thinking model inside of any of those, but I usually leave it on standard thinking. But if I really want a great result and I'm willing to wait, I do turn on extended thinking here. And this prompt actually requires a little bit back and forth conversation because obviously I asked it for a lot here. So I typically like to break it down with a follow-up prompt to go through each of these steps one at a time with me to really flesh this out. So for the values, for example, I would maybe pick 5 from the list that he gave me. It's gonna give you principles, decision filters on how to make decisions here, your weekly routine here, you could expand on that, habit system, thought process, productivity framework, emotional regulation, goal setting, really, really useful once you have this. And what I like to do with this one, once I go back and forth with ChatGPT, I like to turn on the canvas mode here, this option right here, and then ask it to give this to me in a PDF format that I could just download here and save to my Dropbox or to my Google Drive to refer to at any time. Now, this next one is called a second brain prompt. So this is gonna store, structure, and organize everything about me as a second digital brain, okay? So it's gonna be organized into projects, into different areas, resources, archives, use clear folders. And this decided to actually use canvas mode here to organize it. So with these type of things, there's a couple of different tools I like to use sometimes. So this is actually telling me on top to use Notion. Notion is a great place for a database to organize everything. Or you could use Notebook LM, or you could also use ChatGPT projects for this one. So right here, I'm gonna open up the side panel and I could go and create a new ChatGPT projects here and call this my second brain and create that project. And then I could go back to the second brain setup here and I like to move this project to that second brain project here inside of ChatGPT. Now, this specific prompt actually takes some time to set up because you have to create different projects, different areas, give it different resources. But if you do take your time, maybe an hour or two, you could create a really powerful second brain here inside of ChatGPT with this project setting. And you could have it as something that you refer back to all the time. One of my favorite all-time prompts. This next prompt is called the YouTube Virality Blueprint. And this one is obviously very relevant for me, but if you make any kind of content, this could come in handy. Study the top 50 viral videos in my niche of AI. Identify their hooks, their pacing, their story patterns, their thumbnail types, and create a reusable formula I could plug in into that topic. And the reason why I jumped into Gemini for this one, I found Gemini to be far better at finding things that are inside of YouTube than ChatGPT. Obviously, Gemini is owned by Google. They own YouTube. So this will become a better tool for finding that information here. And I could also press the plus sign here. And one of the more recent updates inside of Gemini is you could bring in anything from Notebook LM2. So I have notebooks where I've stored all kinds of YouTube videos in the AI space that I actually like. So I could pull those in if I wanted to. And I could upload any type of files as well from my drive or from my computer. And here's the result, basically analyzed from 2024 to 2026, things related to generative AI, which was part of my prompt here. And this is the anatomy of what makes a viral video. It gave me a hook on how I should start the video here, the pacing, the pattern for the story, the thumbnail types on exactly what's included in the thumbnail, emotional curve, structure, twist, and I could also export this information to a Google Sheet inside of Gemini. And it gave me a lot more useful information here. This one I've actually used multiple different times, and it's actually perfect for any type of content creation that you're trying to do, even if you're trying to do short format outside of YouTube as well. This next one is short and sweet, but it's one of the ones I use probably every single day. So if you write any type of email, if you reply to any type of messages, this one is really, really simple. Rewrite my message so it becomes the clearest, smartest, most persuasive version of itself while keeping my voice identical. And then you paste whatever you wrote. Let's say you wrote an email, paste that here with this, and it's going to give you something that's usually far better than your own writing. The next one is called a marketing angle super prompt. Give me 20 marketing angles for any product. So I'm actually gonna type in our product, Skill Leap AI, which is our education platform. Desire-based angles, fear-based angles, emotional, logic-based. So it's really designed to talk to different types of people that these angles will be relevant for. Each angle must show a new way to position the same product. Now, this is inside of my ChatGPT account, so it knows all about what we do here. That's just based on the memory it has from previous conversations. And it's giving me different angles here that I could position my marketing message across all these different angles here. So this one is really useful if you do any type of marketing. When you are researching a topic, a lot of times you just don't know what you don't know, right? The unknown unknown. So here is what I'm thinking about, and then insert your topic here. I'm just gonna type in stock options, for example. Your job is to tell me important things that I don't know, that I'm underestimating, or that I'm misunderstanding. Now, for this one, I definitely like to use the thinking models for this one, so it could really go to work. And pretty much every time I use this prompt, I will come across something that I did not know that I should even research. So this comes in really handy, especially with the very first prompt I gave you, which is a research prompt, to follow up with this prompt to actually dig a little bit deeper into things that I might not even know to ask or the research did not pull up for me. And as always, typically on the bottom when you're using ChatGPT, it gives you a recommendation on how to continue this conversation. One of my favorite things inside of ChatGPT. So if I don't know how to follow up with this conversation, I always look at the very bottom of the response. Now, another business prompt here. This is called the business architect prompt. Act as a business architect. Turn my business into a streamlined, automated, scalable machine. Redesign my operations, my offer, my team structure, my tools, my pricing, my systems. So this will look at it at so many different angles. The nice thing about these prompts, by the way, is not like you're gonna send this prompt and then you're gonna be getting the final result in the reply. These prompts typically take about 30 minutes of back and forth to really, really dig into the information it gives you on this very first reply here. So I like to follow up, usually one at a time. I would say, let's now focus on operations and let's dig in a little bit deeper. Now let's focus on our offer. Now, the reason why I type in a prompt like this and I actually get a useful reply is I've been using ChatGPT, and with this memory option, it knows just about everything about me. If you are not using it all the time, what I would recommend with all these is actually start a new project. And with these projects here, let me jump into the other one we created. I would actually add files related to everything that is about your business, your operations. And if you don't have those things at this point, one of my favorite things that I've done that's made ChatGPT and Gemini and other tools a lot more useful is I've created a massive directory inside of both Notion, Google Drive, and Dropbox on different things that we use in our business. I've documented all our processes, all our systems, so I don't have to repeat myself ever to ChatGPT. These projects specifically about a topic know everything about our marketing, for example. I have things inside of Notebook LM that do the same type of thing. So make sure everything is organized, or you've talked to ChatGPT enough where he has enough memory about what you do, so you don't have to re-describe your context, what your business is every single time. So this actually knows our business's skill leap, so it's telling me everything about our core offer, about things about our pricing, about your messaging, about our operations, about our automations. And again, I'll have back and forth, spend some time with this, and get a really good system to improve our existing setup. And this next one is called a skill accelerator prompt. And this one will help you learn any skill. So for the skill of, you would type in right here your skill, I'll put digital marketing, create a 30-day plan that includes daily exercises, real-world practice drills, quick wins, assessments, and weekly challenges. And I've been teaching tech for a very long time, almost a decade now. So these type of assessments and these type of quizzes are really useful. So I usually use it as a resource for our courses and things like that. So I know they are handy. It helps with retention. So instead of just watching a video and doing nothing, this will give you something practical that you could follow up with. So I use ChatGPT for this all the time as a resource, but also for myself to learn new topics. And I think you'll find it useful too. Now, this one is called Fix My Thinking Prompt, and it only really works as a follow-up prompt while you're having a conversation, especially if you're brainstorming with ChatGPT or any other chatbot. Analyze my thought process, identify flawed assumptions, biases, emotional distortion, and missing logic, offer healthier, clearer thinking pattern. So if you use this as your thought partner or as your business partner, this is a great follow-up prompt that I use all the time here, especially after I've had a conversation for a little while here, because I could then have my own assumption, change the direction that ChatGPT might be going, and this will help with that. This is called a content factory prompt. Create a content factory for my niche, type in your niche here, include content pillars, 50 long form ideas, 50 short form ideas, scripts, hooks, CTAs, repurpose workflows, weekly posting schedule. This will create an entire marketing engine for you for content creation. Now I'm gonna change it to 10 just for the sake of time here. Again, this gives you the structure, basically the skeleton of how to get started. And then you dive a little bit deeper on each one of these as you have this conversation. And this is one of those other things that making a project around it makes a lot of sense, because you'll be coming back to this one all the time. Here's our content pillar. Here is 10 ideas. They have the title, they have the hook, they have the script breakdown here in bullet point format. They have a CTA that I should mention at the end of the videos, right? This is long form, this is short form. You could see how much information you could extract here just from that single prompt. And it'll just be something that you could continue this conversation with. And as I mentioned, I have about 30 of these. So that was 12. And I'll just kind of go through some of these other ones here, but I'll make this available in a link here. It's on our website. You could download it for free and you could copy and paste. Obviously, some of these will need a placeholder or your niche or your specific request here, but this will create things for Twitter or X here. If you sell products, this one makes sense for you. This one's a good one, character-based rewriting prompt. So this will rewrite things from a different angle. You could put anything here, philosopher, scientist, novelist, for example. This one will help you analyze your audience. This one is great for a rewrite of any emails. This one is really simple, but this ultimate writing prompt improves just about any piece of writing that you have, including things like blogs and longer form content. And you could check out the rest on your own here with this PDF. If you have any favorite prompts that you've been using that you copy and paste all the time, if you wanna share those, please let me know in the comment section here. I also recently made a video like this one, but about ChatGPT tips and tricks that I've gathered in the last couple of years and some new ones too. I'll include that video right over here.